The final type of bonding, which we normally don't see, is metallic bonding. We're going to say metal atoms pull their valence electrons to form an electron C that holds the metal ion together. So here we have an image of the surface of a metal. So just realize, visually, the surface of a metal basically has free-floating electrons all over it. When we talk back about the photoelectric effect in chapter 6 or 7, we talked about having a photon being able to hit the surface of the metal and launching an electron off. It wouldn't be able to do that if it were not for the surface of a metal. The surface of a metal basically just has a bunch of electrons on it. Those electrons, they're not stuck on there really hard. If we have sufficient energy, we can knock one off. Now, metallic bonding, you're normally not going to see. So I wouldn't worry too much about this third type of chemical bonding. Know that it exists, but don't worry too much about what does it look like. The most important ones are ionic bonding and covalent bonding. And remember, ionic bonding is between a cation and an anion. We have a transferring of an electron from one to the other. That's where their charges come into play. And from that, since they have opposite charges, they come together. Covalent bonding is even more important. It's because of covalent bonding that we're going to see things such as Lewis dot structures. Lewis dot structures are based on covalent bonding structures. So it's more important for us to get down the fundamentals of covalent bonding most from this. So just remember the three types of chemical bondings that exist, and remember the features of each.